Welcome back to Breakfast Television. We're sitting at 7:50 on this Wednesday, and time now to talk business. And for that, we turn to our business editor, Mike Eppel. Morning, Mike. Are you making a phone call? Am I interrupting you right now? All right, we'll just give Mike another second here to join us. We've got plenty to talk about. Good morning.
Hi, how are you?
I'm very well, thanks. Kind of you to join us.
Thank you. Having some technological difficulties on my end. Otherwise known as how to work the telephone.
And you know what? I'm right there with you, my friend. I am technologically challenged. So now that we have you, let's jump right into it. Let's start with CN Rail.
Yes, speaking of challenges, what we are seeing right now with this Indigenous blockade on the rail line between Toronto and Montreal near Belleville, and another one in BC related to that pipeline protest in British Columbia. CN is saying that they're, you know, basically seeing a lot of shipments held back for the time being because they can't get through. So, you know, what are the economic implications of this? How long it lasts, what the scenario is for the Irving Oil Pipeline scenario out in New Brunswick. The largest refinery is not getting any crude by rail through CN. So this could affect the Eastern Canadian supply of gasoline. So there's a lot of implications. Remember, Sarah, that it was last November, CN had a 9-day strike. And at the time, it actually curtailed quite a bit of economic growth for the Canadian market. So again, it's just early days, but nevertheless, something to watch.
Okay. How about low carbon economy? Are we seeing negative economic implications with that?
We don't know. And that is the blunt assessment from the regulator, the overseer of the Canadian banks. Jeremy Rudin at the office of the superintendent of the banks. They basically are trying to figure out what the shift to a low-carbon economy means for the financial system. Mm-hmm. That's their job. It's risk assessment. And this all part and parcel of the finance ministry. The upcoming budget's going to be all about climate change, among other things. But they're forthcoming and saying it could be good, you know, depending on technologies, but we don't know what those technologies are yet, so you're moving away potentially from sort of tried and true in the economy, the growth in the energy sector, to carbon neutrality. Banks should be prepared for it, insurance companies, pension plans, because of the risk assessment that they're just not sure whether it's going to be good or bad. So that's the challenges that we face, though, right, with the changing strategies. The funny thing, too, was, not funny, but one issue as well, even though the banks are talking about, you know, shifting to green investments, they're actually loaning more to the energy sector than they have in quite some time. So we do have these dichotomies, so to speak, in the banking system right now.
All right. Thanks very much, Mike. We've run out of time,
but
I'll see you at the same time tomorrow, hopefully, if you can get dialed in.
I'll figure it out. Maybe.
See you then. If you'd like to hear more from Mike Eppel, you can tune in to 660 News. Let's go ahead and take a look at the markets.
This portion of BT is brought to you by 660 News, Calgary's breaking news, weather, and traffic station.